Once upon a time, which is the way all good stories should begin, there were two little boys who lived in a far-off land called Palestine. Their names were Jesus and John. John was older than Jesus by about 6 months. Their moms were kinswomen, so that made these two not only best friends, but cousins. They loved to play together whenever their families gathered. The boys had a lot in common. It seems that a fellow named Gabriel, who was really an angel, visited Jesus' mom, Mary, and John's dad, Zechariah, before the children were born to bring them the good news. As the boys grew into young men, they began to walk down separate roads. John left his home and lived in the desert. He wore a camel pelt for clothes and ate locusts and wild honey for dinner. John got himself in trouble all the time because he preached about a special man coming to save the people. The king did not like this and threw him in jail. Jesus stayed in his hometown working as a carpenter. When it was time for him to leave home, he went to the big city called Jerusalem. On his way there, he found John. He was baptizing people in the River Jordan. Jesus stood in line. John saw him and was happy in his heart that Jesus wanted to be baptized with the others. You see, John knew that his cousin was not only his friend, but the Messiah, that special man who had come to save his people. The end. Please forgive my bit of fanciful historical fiction, but I have often wondered about the relationship between Jesus and St. John the Baptist. There isn't much written about John in the Gospels, but I imagine that these two were really close. When Our Lady was expecting Jesus and visited Elizabeth, who was also going to have a baby, her cousin's child leapt with joy within her. Jesus and John knew each other before they were born. Jesus calls John a prophet, the new Elijah. They spent a lifetime together. Just think about how heartbroken Jesus must have been when he was told of John's death. He took a boat and went off by himself. Can't you just feel the human Jesus sitting all alone somewhere grieving for his best friend? Thinking of Jesus and his humanity makes it easier somehow to connect with his divinity. I have kids. I saw them playing in our backyard doing what kids do. I heard their squabbles and laughter. I see them now as grown women grappling with all that life throws at them. When Jesus acts like the rest of us, this mystery suddenly makes more sense. I think we tend to downplay the man part of Jesus because what the God in him did for us is so spectacular. His relationship with John was so human. Imagining these two boys playing, running after some baby goats or climbing a tree makes me see the Christ as a regular kid, a little boy who grew up to be the Savior of the world. If ever there is tomorrow and we are not together, there is something you must always remember. You are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. But the most important thing is, even if we're apart, I'll always be with you.